Welcome to Factorio, let's start automating. My name is Nida, so this is episode 17 of our Let's Play campaign. So what are we going to do today? We are going to start utilizing some of our advanced oil products. So these advanced oil products are actually, they are stockpiling, they're good here. And from there on, we are going to figure out what to do. However, since we are going to work very focused on robots. Oh, the music stopped. That's too bad. We could also take a look at our solar panels, or so we get some solar power in. But you know what? At this point, I'm going to be like, you know, I think we'll just survive with our coal. And then as soon as we get robots, then we can have the robots do the hard work, because that is hard work. So one of the things that's not really great right now is the fact that our red circuits are not really working as fast as they could be. So the one thing I could do was actually expand out here. So let's do some more here. That's actually not the one we want, to take the shortest one here. So we want to prepare for the future. This one will be able to make the Mark III assemblers that we don't have. So we'll just leave that space here, but that will allow us to start making some of these. And let's also make some productivity modules and some efficiency modules. They're really nice to have, so let's get all of them. Why not? Why not indeed? And I think we'll do sort of the usual thing we could do here. That one. No. That one. Wow, that science is just going, isn't it? There. That was lab research. Good. We are going to keep doing a lot of research here. Some of this might be expensive. This one is... No, that's not very expensive. Really? Why not? That's expensive. Let's get some robot things going, just because. All right. So we are going to get this part. Let's make sure that we have... Where are you going to be? You don't have any locations that you can output things. Except if I did that, and I did, I don't know, like that maybe. So you can go from here to here. Oh, we are missing a few of these. That's more research. Now the research is just killing it. And this one, we'll just get one stack of that. And, you know, I don't actually think I need this. I can just do this. Yeah. And then copy paste, so we get the same. And you're gonna grab from here. Great. Here though, as always, here. Okay, so what else we want to make? We want to make... How can I just not get this? And that one, that one, that one. These locations, and that was rogue worker robot. Wow, we're just, now get more upgrades to robots. All right, so what we want to make is, actually we want to make some of the simpler parts. These are, this is going to be here and here. The first logistics chest that we need. I will, at some point, I guess, make a dedicated build, or what do we say? What should we say? The masterclass for our logistics. So if you're not familiar with logistics, we'll try to explain it just in brief detail, but not go sort of overly into it. At this point, we have two types of chests. And that means those are the only ones we can do. That is a passive storage chest and a logistics chest. That's pretty good, because we can make do with what we have here. But there are three more chests, so let's make room for this. The way I want to make it is kind of a weird way, but I want to do that one. Then I want to put it out on a belt, because all of these are going to need chests. Then also want to put it into a box, because you always need a box of boxes. It's very meta. Let's do a box of boxes. So you're going to grab that one, and that one, and that one, and that one. And then you can... We're probably going to need this one as well. Yeah, we are. We absolutely are. So let's get that. Oh, that science is just way too fast for us. Let's get some military just to be ahead of the curve. Let's see. That one can go here. Also, we just want one stack of that. And that one. And now is actually the time when things are getting iffy, because that's kind of different. So this is reserved. Let's build that one. This will be gonna have to get it all the way because these chests will have the same recipe. They just have different outputs. But this one is the one we were kind of inching our way towards. Let's get a tank because that's, oh, look at that. The tank is much darker than it was before. Nice. And, oh, power poles. We have other stuff we want to build out here. Like we want to build, since we can get, yeah, we want to build beacons at this location and we want to make like substations, I think. This one, however, you are going to get from here, and, oops. There, that should be good. Ta-da, and this will stack too. And now already I'm making mistakes, I think. These stack to 10, so let's get it to 5. Do we have this one? Not yet. But we can just smash some steel into this one to make it go faster. Also, we can take that one because we want it. All right, so I'm going to make 2 of these. And no, I'm not. I'm just going to pick up some of those now. So that will be a big step forward, but it doesn't have to be right now. We just need to make sure that our RoboPorts are being built because RoboPorts take forever and they use a ton of red circuits. So the red circuits have been kind of idling. And therefore, we also need to go up back up here. So there have been some comments about all of this thing. One of the comments I really liked, so thank you for that. The other comments were like, yeah, okay. This one, though, I think I'll actually do something different. Now, the problem with this build is that the oil is coming in and it'll go into these. Now, these are stalling because we do have enough petroleum, but what happens if petroleum starts dipping? Well, petroleum starts dipping. Oh, the science is going way too fast. What do we want? Logistics, robot logistics. Let's do that so we can get some logistics chest as well. Let's walk through it. So just trying to illustrate what will happen. If this starts dipping below, then eventually this pump will start firing on. And when that goes on, then I'll top up here. But what if we just don't have enough crude oil? And we just keep emptying this and it goes completely empty and the crude oil just can't keep up. Well, at this point, this pump will be active, which means the oil coming in here will go into the bad petroleum build first and then never get to the more important one. That's a mistake. So what we should do is actually saying we want the oil coming in first. This is weird, but it actually needs to come in first to the other build. Ugh. It did not want to get this in my inventory, but I guess I did. Now I don't want it in my inventory, so let's help getting it out. There we go. That's gonna be kind of iffy. That. All right, let me just see how long it can reach. It can reach out there, so let's get it out there. There, there. That's correct. That's not correct. So I wanted to get it in here and then that one. So basically it goes in here. Is that going to make any difference? Let me just try this on for size and to see how it feels. What we're doing now is, now of course this won't work. I'm going to take the oil out from this side. Boom, logistics bots. We can take energy distribution. We can also open up deeper science. Oh, let's get some inserter capacity. That's a nice one. And, all right, so what does this do? Wow, that's too much. Put it up there. All right, so now the oil, crude oil, goes in here. And then it goes into the first one. It'll still speed up to this one. You know what? This, I don't really think I want this. I think I have enough at this point. And when I need more, then I can get it. So, yep. That's not going to work, by the way. So, basically, we only have this part. And when we need more oil, we'll get more. There were some comments about the setup here and whether that was correct. And I feel pretty confident that it is correct. Basically what happens is I prioritize lubricant first. Only when lubricant is done, is enough, then I'll convert it into the light oil. Light oil will go into this part. And there's a bit of a comment like, if this one stops, well, this one stops only blocks these ones. It doesn't block the direct production. It only blocks the light oil cracking output. And if it blocks the light oil cracking output, then the only place the light oil can go is filling up this box until it reaches 10K, and then it actually stalls. But if it stalls because this one's full, this one's full, this one's full, then it's fine. Just let it stall. Let it stall, my friends. What are we not getting enough of? We're simply not getting enough. That's so weird. But I guess this has been stockpiling, or it's been working on two sides of the belts. This is working fast enough. They're all working. It just feels really slow. All right, that was what we wanted to do. Now we have another thing that is super important, and that's going to start us on building the robots. Well, the robots will need a few different things. Let's have a look at what it takes to make robots. Robots use flying robot frames. The funny thing with robots, though, is that it doesn't take very long to make a robot. It takes half a second to make a robot if you have the flying robot frame. So the focus is going to be on the flying robot frame. Steel, we got it. Batteries, we got it. Electronic circuits, we got it. Electric engines, we don't have it, but it's only used for one thing, and this is the thing, so we don't need to make it anywhere else. This is on a 20-second cycle, so let's look at our electric engines. That's on a 10-second cycle. So this is the interesting thing where I always somehow make a mistake. It has to be like this. That was inserter capacity. What else can we get that's interesting? There's not really anything that's like super interesting for us to get. Explosive rocketry. That's actually really good, and we need it for the Spidertron later on. We're kind of running out of things that we super want, but let's start taking some other things that we wouldn't mind having. Now, that means I can do one assembler of electric engines on a 10-second cycle. So over 20 seconds, which is this cycle, it makes two, and that means it can feed these two. All right, that's awesome. Now, what else? We need to make sure that that's not a good place because of the input of light oil or input of lubricants. So let's put it at this location, because we also know that the engine unit is on a 10-second cycle. So this is even with that one, which is even with these two. This is good. So can we do a way that all the other items also come in here? Let's build a few of these since we have a bit of excess iron here in our inventory. What if we build it like this? I want to just make it a small and compact location. Right, this one needs iron, gears, and tubes. Right? And that needs to come in from two different locations. The thing we could do is we could say that this, there is a room for it right here. That one. And then you grab it here. So that's going to be two of the things. That could, for example, be... Hold on. This one requires steel as well. So if we can get the steel in this belt, then you can leech steel from here. And you can leech steel from here. And you can leech steel from here. Yeah. That's something. That's something. What's going to be on the other side of that? All right. So let's try to sort of build it. Can I illustrate it somehow? Do I have the opportunity to do this? I think I do. All right. So this one, I want to have half the belt with pipes and the other half a belt. This is just an indicator, a visual indicator, right? So it doesn't do anything. It just gives you the opportunity to see what I have here. So what I have here is I'm going to get steel, because steel will be used for engines and it'll be used for the loaded robot frames. All right. So what do we need? What about the green one? The green one is needed here as well, but not here. So what if I put greens on this, on the other side? Let's do that. It looks good because this is just low quantity. This doesn't need to be like everything. I don't need 20 of these, but let's make 10 of those, because then I can make one robot every second. That's pretty good, right? So what we need now is actually, we need, all right, hello there. And what do we have? Oh, we can get production science, fancy. We cannot get this one yet. Okay, so let's work our way towards that part. And you need batteries, yes. And what else do you need than batteries? And nothing else. And you need an output. So I'm going to build it on two sides, just for now. Yeah, so you're going to get output here. That's going to be... Oh, I don't have it. Remember, these are just indicators. This will be batteries. You know what? Why not just use the same belt for both? Yeah? I think that's better. At least for now. Input, input, output, output. So we just have to get the batteries on the inside and then we can use the outside. Well, there we have it. Can we also make sure that it gets powered? Huh. Refuel this. Okay, hold on. One thing I want to see now, I do a copy. I want to see how close can we make it? See, that's a problem. What if I make it like this? Yeah, see, then we have issues. That one actually has to be a reach across. Ah. And that means I need red. This one has to be a red one. Because it reaches 5 locations, and that one also has to be a red. Yeah. Okay, so the only thing we need is now this one. How do we do this? Well, this one can also be a... No, it can't. It needs one in between, so it needs to be... Okay. Well, we're not quite there yet. This one is a battery input. We can figure out where that is. How close can we make? We can make this one. This one will be pipes. No. This one will be gears. That's one option, but then I need iron on the same belt. So what if I get the like iron in? Because it's really crowded. This one needs 2 inputs in. And this one needs 1 input. And then I need that one out here. Let's see, where could we make it? I could make it sort of like this, maybe. And then basically have iron coming in here. Boom, yes. Right? Pick up, delivery. Maybe even double pickup here. And then some pipes. Okay, is this an okay solution? It kind of is, but it also kind of isn't because it's too close. I'd like to make it just a bit further this way and then a bit further in. So yeah, that's kind of why we need robots. Oh, I can build a power armor. That's sweet. Except I can't because it takes blue circuits. But I like this. I'm going to copy this because I need to rebuild it and I can't remember it if I start removing it. So I'm just going to take all of this and then I'm going to move it away because I didn't like the location of it. I mean, it's kind of silly, but I didn't know how big it was going to be, so. That's a very nice compact build. So this is kind of how you do it first. This is how I do it all the time. I always start by just finding out the ratio. When I have the ratios, then I can start seeing if there are any just nice patterns. We can start at like the same height as that one. That kind of makes sense, right? Let's see. So this one is going to be our iron inbound. Iron inbound, yes. Iron comes up here and goes into these two. That will also need some kind of power. And of course, that's going to be just fine because we don't need any more. This one is going to be an input and that's going to be an input. Oof. Can we remember what we're supposed to get on each? I think this one's actually fine. There. All right, that's good. This one, I have no clue what I'm supposed to get on each. Ah, that'll look better. It'll look parallel to that one. All right. Let's get this one up there and then figure out how we do power. That one. And I feel the one that should be in here. Yeah, definitely. That looks good, right? Because the thing is, it's repeatable pattern. So once we start repeating this pattern here, then this one, everything will be powered like that. Cool. Yes, it'll be work. It'll work. And I'm gonna have batteries. All right. So this one we will have steel plus green. Let's see if we can now get it in. I'm gonna put it in now because I feel somewhat confident about this build. And it doesn't matter which side things goes on, so I can take steel on this side. There we go. And balance before and after. And then I have a steel. Nope, steel's coming here. Nope, that's not steel. This is steel. All right, never mind. All of this is just incorrect because I forgot the steel was further up. So, steel, jump, and that one. What? Really? Oh, yeah, it's because I want the blue on that belt. Perfect. Got one. Let's see. Working our way towards this one. Low density structures. At this point now, we're doing kind of the same as we've been doing before. Just cleaning out all the signs we can get. Oh, no. My inventory is empty. Well, we can get it. All right, I'm looking forward to it. I think we'll get robots, but I don't think we'll get much more than just robots. All right, look at this. This is what happened. All of the red circuits are getting used, and it's great because, yeah, red circuits were stockpiling, and red circuits should never be stockpiling. I want more of these. Do I have enough of this? Yes. Oh, one more thing. Since we get robots soon, let's also just start. Yeah, you know what? I want all of it. There. Might eat. No, yeah, that's too much. There. We want a lot. So just start working on it. Keep working. It's going to be great. Everyone will be happy. Let's see. I only got 10 splitters. That's not enough. I want more. And 100 of these. Sure. Let's also get a few more. Good. That should keep us covered. I'll get a few of these. We also got some speed modules and productivity modules. This one's also good. I'll just take a few so it can keep flowing. What about roboports? I'll get some roboports here. Yes, please. Yes, please. All right. We're starting. You can see that things are going on here. Things are happening. Boom. Get that out of there. I just have some junk in my inventory here. All right. Here's the batteries that we absolutely need now. It is on this belt. We need it for this part here. And that's going to be iron. So this one will be there. And iron just goes in here. This is going to be super simple. It's not even going to be high quantities of iron. It's just going to be like mediocre amounts. And here comes the iron. It's freshly balanced. I'll take it. Ta-da, we got we don't have everything in. We almost have everything in. We're gonna need some lubricant. There. And I'm going to just take it so I know where to branch it from. That one. Nope. Yeah. Oh, it's not enough. Ta-da. Is it working? Yes, it got that one. Low density. Now we can get here. So we want to take this. All right, let's see. Inbound. See, this is again where it's super efficient for us to have blueprints. Even though we can't build stuff with blueprints, then it's still super efficient. There. All right, what is happening? This one's not working. Why is it not working? Oh no, this is an idiotic one. Okay, yeah, can't build as long as the train is moving. No, you're moving too fast. Oh, look at this. Look at how stupid it is. That's kind of bad, but it's not going to be a problem for this one because it's already stuck. But it needs to get stuck. That's actually really funny. Huh, never noticed that. I didn't even notice that. But it did get it. Yeah, boom. Utility science, that's fancy. Nothing of what we get with utility science will help us. But we can start working on sort of other things and that will help us. Lasers might be nice to have. Opens up another few other things. And again, I want to do this part and just... Now we can hold down the... What? What's the problem? Fast inserter? Sometimes it's easier actually to look at it on a map. Okay, so there's something up here. We also forgot the lights. It's kind of important. Is this not the same? Why not? Oh, it goes input, output. Boom. The three, that's four. That's five. That's six. That's seven. That's eight. That's nine. And that's 10. Oh yeah, that's gonna give us one robot per second. We will easily get what we need. But the thing is this, you might think that this is completely insane to build this amount of robots per second. It is, but it serves another purpose as well. And that's the fact that we are actually preparing this for the utility science. That's laser turrets. We want laser turrets. Not that we can support it, but laser turrets are just fancy. Let's see this one. The distance here is that much. And then the distance here must be the same. Yeah. And I will now go this into an assembler that will make robots. And this is where things get super beautiful. Look at that. Because we actually have green circuits on this belt. Isn't that wonderful? We don't have the red circuits, so we can't make logistics parts. But I really don't ever focus on logistics parts early. You know what? I'll put it there. And we're now going to do something fancy. There. I'm going to make an inserter here. But this is where there's a nice little circuit trick. And we just need one wire for it. So you wire up the RoboPort with the inserter. Did you know you could do that? You can. Let's make sure that things get powered down here. That's gonna be mean to build all this manually. If only we had robots to help us build it, huh? If only. Okay, let's chop. There. Okay, so this one has two things that it can output. And I'm just gonna show it by, yeah, I'm gonna make one more. By making it into a power pole so you can see what's there. It doesn't. This one can tell you what is in the logistics network. Since we don't have a logistics network, we don't really have anything. But it can also read the amount of robots. And then it gets here, it will output available robot logistics robots as X, total logistics robots as Y, available construction robots as Z or Z, and total construction bots as T. So I want to take T, the T signal, which basically means how many total robots are there? And I just say, you know what? At this point, I just want 500. If I can get 500, oh boy, am I gonna be happy. So that is gonna be the objective for us, is to build this so that we can get to 500 robots. And then unfortunately, all of the rest of the stuff is super complicated to build because it's such a convoluted build. And laser turrets are done. I'm gonna do one more. That one doesn't need to be there, but I'm gonna do one more thing because at the late game, we are going to need some. That's my first logistics chest. So I'll put a logistics storage chest and I'll actually get it with a storage filter so that it can only store electric engines. That's a really neat little trick to do. And I wanted to store four of those. That's a lot, but I'll get it. Oh, science. Keep the science rolling. Oh, now it's time to get uranium. We want to, in this space, also build some nuclear power because it's kind of, if this is a starter series, we really should be also making, showing how to do uranium power or nuclear power. So we'll definitely do that. But I mean, now we're getting into the realm of robots. We're going to start talking a bit more about how robots work, how you can use them, all that good stuff, when we actually have them, because I think that's a better time. At this point, it's all about just building the damn thing here. And not that one. Actually, not even this one. There. And let's get the lubricant in as well. And at the end of this, I will have forgotten something. There, lubricant is working. This belt is working, so that's good. Let's do the next belt here. I sure as hell hope this works. But otherwise, that's a lot of things that we haven't. And let's build the lights, because they are more important than inserters, apparently. And then, because the whole thing will start firing up when we build inserters. So let's get the other stuff first. There, there. Ta-da. Input, 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 input. We haven't done these. Let's do those first. Input, 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 output, input, output. Things are working, I think. Certainly not the fastest way of building this, but I'll try to make it consistent. I think that's more important. Input, output, input, output. Oh no! All right, whatever. I don't bother going back for more. I should have picked those up. I should have known. I should have known. Input, output, input, output. Oh, we're getting stuff. We are getting stuff. We're getting robots, aren't we? I think we are. I'm going to build this. Otherwise, if I get disturbed on this, there will be no coming back. So in the next episode, we will actually start using the robot for something. Now that we have built the robots, it's too little time left for me to actually start. Okay, so how are we going to do it? How are we going to make everything available to the robots? Because that's kind of a big thing that doesn't really make a lot of sense if you, well, if you don't know it, then it doesn't make any sense. Oops, nope. Let's actually do this. And, oh, it's still more. It's a lot of inserters we need here. That one somehow got missed, and that one got missed. All right, I'm just gonna run up and see if everything is working. If you spot something missing, do make sure to yell out in the comment section. That's what it's there for, yelling out about missing inserters. Let's see, does it work? Huh? We have 23 robots. How about that? We are so rich. We are so rich. Why did I do that? It's gonna get plenty. There we go, we got robots, and this is our robot network. Doesn't do much, but it is there. We have robots, boys and girls. There we go. I'm super happy about this, and we've been clearing out like a ton of science here. So when we start working with the robots, what is the things we want to do? Well, we want to upgrade belts from yellow to red belts, so things go faster. We want to upgrade stone furnace to steel furnace, so we double the production. We want to build solar panels, because that's a lot of build that we can't do. We want to build our wall defenses, so I don't have to run around doing it myself. We want to be able to repair the wall defenses as we go along. And that's a lot of things, right? There's a ton of things we now want to do robots for. And but power, remember power. I always forget it, right? You know that. But I always forget to upgrade the power. But we need to upgrade power, because robots will use a lot of power. So that's all we can make in this episode. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked it. I hope it is not too fast on this one. We did design it. The process is really like find out the ratio of buildings towards each other. Figure out how big you want to build it. Build some kind of module that can handle the inputs and outputs in an efficient way. And then scale it up. Right? Then at that point, and then you just scale it up at that from that point. Cool. Thank you very much for watching. And as always, remember, stay effective.